Jaguar just has revealed the quickest passenger car the company has ever produced. If you're British, however, you might be disappointed to see that one of your nation's most storied automobile makers has gone and put the steering wheel on the wrong side. Jaguar will only make 300 of the new 592-horsepower Jaguar XESV Project 8, which can go from 0 to 60 miles an hour in just 3.3 seconds. But all of them will have the driver's seat on the left-hand side. That will be fine for most of the world, but in the United Kingdom and a few other countries, cars drive on the left side of the road. Cars made for those countries usually have the controls on the right side for a better view of oncoming traffic. UK drivers can still drive left-handed cars, it's just a bit awkward to do so. The four-door sedan will have a top speed of 200 miles. That means this car is just as fast, in terms of top speed, as the Jaguar F-Type SVR Coupe, which had been Jaguar's fastest car. But this car is even quicker to accelerate. The XESV Project 8 is a version of Jaguar's $35,000 entry-level model. This version, though, will cost £150,000 in the United Kingdom. That's about $195,000, but Jaguar Land Rover hasn't announced exact pricing for the United States yet. The all-wheel drive sedan will have a 5.0-liter supercharged V8, the most powerful ever used in a Jaguar road car, and an 8-speed automatic transmission. Customers outside the United States will be able to get the car without back seats in order to make the car lighter. When included, the back seats will be heavily contoured to hold occupants in place during hard turns. Additionally, the car's body is made primarily from light but expensive carbon fiber. The carbon fiber hood, for instance, will be 6.6 pounds lighter than the aluminum hood usually used on the Jaguar XE. Buyers will be able to customize their cars with a choice of 10,000 different exterior colors, according to Jaguar. And despite its aggressive nature, the car will come with ample entertainment technology including a large central computer screen and 4G Wi-Fi. Jaguar Land Rover, which also makes Land Rover SUVs, is based in Great Britain but is owned by India's Tata Motors.
Luxury automaker Jaguar revealed a hand-built high-performance sedan dubbed the XESV Project 8. Featuring a top speed of 200 miles per hour and 592 horsepower. The vehicle boasts carbon ceramic braking, silicon nitride ceramic wheel bearings and a 5-liter, supercharged 8-cylinder gasoline engine. The model is a tricked-out version of the Jaguar XE, making its official debut Friday at England's Goodwood Festival of Speed. It goes 0 to 60 mph in 3.3 seconds. It's the most powerful, agile and extreme performance Jaguar road car ever produced, the UK automaker said. Always follow local speed limits, Jaguar reminds us. Sure, whatever you say. The company will manufacture 300 units of the Collector's Edition model, which technicians will assemble in Coventry, England. Pricing was not immediately available, but it won't be pretty.
Jaguar has unveiled its XESV Project 8, its most powerful and track-focused road car yet. The British brand has removed the camouflage from the new sports sedan after its tease back in May and revealed full technical details of the new machine. As previously revealed, the Project 8 is powered by a 441 kilowatts per 700 newton-meters supercharged 5-liter V8. The most potent engine the company has ever installed into one of its road-going cars. It transmits its power to the road via an all-wheel drive system to ensure the four-door sedan can race from 0 to 100 km in a supercar-like 3.7 seconds. The suspension has been heavily modified, with stiffer springs and manually adjustable dampers for a more controlled ride. The ride height can be lowered up to 15 mm for track use. Braking is handled by Jaguar's new carbon ceramic braking package. Jaguar is also claiming an industry first for use of Formula One-style silicone nitride wheel bearings. The body has been heavily modified with wider aluminium front and rear guards to accommodate wider tires, and carbon fiber has been used to craft much of the aggressive body kit, which includes a manually adjustable rear wing. The aerodynamic elements are hugely significant beyond 150 mph, even more so beyond 180 mph, said Jaguar chief designer, Ian Callum. "This is one of the most extreme vehicles we have ever created, but still very much a Jaguar. The Project 8 will only be built in left-hand drive. A strange decision for an English car maker. Only 300 examples of the Project 8 will be produced, and each will be hand-built at Jaguar's newest VO Technical Center." Special Operations Managing Director John Edwards explained that the ethos behind Project 8, which follows the F-type-based Project 7, was to push the limits of the still relatively new performance division of Jaguar Land Rover. SVO's raison d'etre is to produce handle vehicles that push the boundaries in terms of luxury, performance and all-terrain capability, Edwards said. Project 8 is a great example of what happens when enthusiastic designers, engineers and manufacturing specialists are given the opportunity to create an extreme performance sports car without compromise. Project 8 will be assembled by hand in the newest VO Technical Center, and we're confident that our enthusiastic and demanding clients will love driving Project 8 as much we do. Jaguar will offer two versions of the XESV Project 8, a four-seater and a two-seat track pack that features racing seats and harnesses. Pricing in Europe will start at £149,995, £264,620 New Zealand dollars, and Jaguar is offering a range of optional extras, including the ability to create your own bespoke model with 10,000 custom colors to choose from. The XESV Project 8 will make its public debut at the Goodwood Festival of Speed, which opens early Friday.
Aston Martin has been playing with the concept of an electric Rapide for a while now, but the engineers in Gaydon have never followed through with the production version. Now, after a few false starts, the company has unveiled plans to offer 155 Albanian Lex electric Rapide coupes in 2019. The Rapide will be developed alongside the team at Williams Advanced Engineering, and shares plenty with the upcoming Rapide AMR. Aston Martin is promising the car will feel like the V12 model in the corners, and won't have its sensuous lines ruined by the swap from internal combustion to battery power. Of course, the driving experience will be vastly different in the Rapide. The V12 whale that defines the current Rapide and Vanquish will be notably absent in the all-electric model, but on the other hand you'll have access to huge reserves of torque from standstill. Beyond the fact it'll be a pure EV, Aston Martin is remaining tight-lipped on the performance of its first electric car. Around the launch of the initial Rapide concept, CEO Andy Palmer told Autocar a production model could be available in rear drive and all-wheel drive trim, with power outputs ranging from 550 to 800 horsepower, 410 to 597 kilowatts. Those power outputs are on a par with what we might expect of a high-performance EV in 2017, although the 200-mile, 322 kilometers range mentioned in the same Autocar article lags well behind what Tesla is offering in the Model S. Aston Martin says it will be releasing more information about range and power in the lead up to the car's launch in 2019. Having unveiled the Rapide concept back in October 2015, we reach another milestone with the confirmation that we are now putting the first all-electric Aston Martin into production, said Palmer in a press release. The internal combustion engine has been at the heart of Aston Martin for more than a century, and will continue to be for years to come. Rapide will showcase Aston Martin's vision, desire and capability to successfully embrace radical change, delivering a new breed of car that stays true to our ethos and delights our customers.
British sports car maker Aston Martin has scaled back production plans for its first electric model after cash-strapped investment partner Lyko pulled out of the project, chief executive Andy Palmer told Reuters on Monday. The result, though, may be an even more exclusive car, aimed at customers who consider Tesla's top-of-the-range $130,000, $171,400 Model S to be a little too run-of-the-mill. Aston Martin will build only 155 of its Rapid E, about a third of the initial plan, and lean more heavily on Formula One engineering specialist Williams after the withdrawal of Chinese TV and smartphone vendor Lego, Palmer said. The setback in Aston's response underscore the challenges and risks niche car makers face as they scramble to address future demand for electrification from consumers and regulators. The privately held Aston Martin brand benefits from the endorsement of fictitious spy James Bond, but it lacks the backing of a large automotive parent that many rivals enjoy. "We've decided to make this car rare, which will obviously tend to push the price higher," Palmer said. Aston Martin now plans to proceed independently, funding further development of Rapid E by ourselves. Palmer agreed to be interviewed after sources told Reuters Aston Martin's partnership with Lego had unraveled. Unveiling the alliance in February last year, Lego and Aston pledged to launch an all-electric version of the Rapid E sedan in 2018. But the Chinese conglomerate has since slashed its electric car investments, including its U.S. startup Faraday Future's planned $1.3 billion factory in Nevada. Some Faraday suppliers, including seatmaker Futurus and media provider Mill Group, have sued the company for non-payment, according to court records. Spokesmen for Lego and Faraday did not respond to requests for comment on the end of the Aston partnership. Aston Martin declined to discuss its partner's business. Aston returned to profit in the first quarter, a decade after it was sold by Ford. Now owned by private equity groups Investi Industrial and Kuwait's Investment Dar, the company is rolling out a new model each year under a tough recovery plan drawn up by Palmer, who joined from Nissan in 2014. Without Lego's backing, the sports car maker, based in Gaydon, Warwickshire, is pushing ahead as sole investor in the electric car, after paring down production and pushing back the launch date to 2019. The plan won board approval on June 21. Aston will start taking orders next month with 10% down payments on the Rapid E, priced just shy of £200,000, $336,000 in its home market before incentives. That's a significant premium on the £150,000 entry ticket for its V12 model, whose 5.9-liter engine develops 470 horsepower. Batteries will come from a new production facility built by a consortium led by Williams Advanced Engineering, the F1 team's technical division, with matched British government funding. Williams, which supplies power packs to the Formula E electric car racing series, also built the Rapid E prototype unveiled in 2015. Beyond the Rapid E, Aston's first full production battery car will be an electric version of the DBX crossover it is launching in 2019, hoping for a repeat of the success that greeted its DB11 coupe, with a little help from the latest Bond film. "The Rapid E project was always about learning in readiness for the DBX derivative," Palmer said. "We can do that through a limited series.